Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Now I just finished filming a video talking about the differences between a Place Diverter and a Berkeley Jet-O-Vator. And if you haven't seen that video, definitely jump in the channel and check it out. But on that video, I only focused on the mechanical end of the two units. I did not go into very much detail at all of how the Jet-O-Vator works on this Berkeley unit. So today I'm gonna go ahead and give you a detailed look of how this functions, how it's set up, and how it's all controlled. Okay guys, in the previous video where I talked about the differences of the Place Diverter and this Jet-O-Vator, I briefly mentioned it, just kind of skimmed over it, but I was discussing that this unit's operated by a cable. It's actually actuated or reacts off of the steering cable. Super clever setup, but it's a little bizarre and it takes a little bit to get your mind around. So I'm gonna go through and do the best that I can to show and explain how this all operates. Now in order to do so, I'm gonna break this into two sections. We're gonna go ahead and show you how it all operates on the end of the pump, but also show you how the electric motor and cable operates, and then I'll kind of tie the two together of how they both function together. Now, the reason why I have to do it that way is since I don't have this pump in a boat and everything reacts off of the transom, I don't think I'm actually gonna be able to get this mocked up and operate because it's just gonna end up pushing the transom and not actuating the pump. But I'll do my best to go ahead and get all this set up and explain it so you have a good understanding of how it works. All right, so here's the main control box for this unit. Briefly mentioned, it's ran off of an electric motor and just has four wires off the back of it here. It has two wires, one for each direction of the motor, a ground wire, and a signal for your potentiometer for your trim gauge. Now we'll go ahead and pop this cover off, and you can see inside have here the potentiometer for the trim gauge, and I actually had mine fail quite a while ago, and so I ended up buying a fuel sender and basically just made a new mount for it, bolted it up in here, made some new arms, and had a trim gauge that was fully operational again. Another thing to discuss are these limit switches here, and these are adjustable. You do need to go ahead and get these set up, and they are to kill power to the motor so you don't overextend on either direction this motor and worm gear setup. Now, I have had these set up incorrectly. It does overextend this motor, and then is what happened is we had the Jet-O-Vator stuck in the up position on the lake, which ended our day early. So it takes a little bit of fine tuning. You can just go ahead and adjust them back here with these screws, and you can see the slots, and it's something pretty easy that you can do with just trial and error with the boat on the trailer. Essentially is what I do is I go ahead and get everything adjusted so those kick off right before the nozzle hits its end stop on the pump in both directions, and you're good to go. Now this is just ran by a old GM window motor, and again, we had that fail on us and we ordered a new motor, and you can see the part number there, just 42-13. And I just looked this up again before I made the video, and it showed up as a mid-60s Corvette window lift motor. It pretty much any GM motor from the 60s and 70s looks like a compatible fit for those, and they just go ahead and bolt on and hooks up into this worm drive here. Now I'll go ahead and grab a battery here and see if I can't show you how this operates. All right, so I got the battery set up and we'll go ahead and power this up, and you can see how this will take the spinning motion of that motor and it's gonna react on this Bowden cable here. And I'll just go ahead and make contact and it just runs. Now my limit switches are adjusted so you can hear where it clicks off, and I'll take my other wire and spin it back. The amount of time that that motor ran, that is the full travel of the Jet-O-Vator. So that's gonna take it from either the full up or full down position to the opposite position. So it's still pretty quick, even though it's an older system. Now, we'll grab the other end of this cable. All right, I had to go ahead and set the camera down so that way I could grab this cable. And I'm gonna go ahead and run the motor one more time to show you what's happening on the other end of the cable here. So this is the cable that actuates the Jet-O-Vator, and here obviously you see the end of it, but I'll go into a little bit more detail in a second, but this cable actually bolts into the transom. It doesn't hook up to the Jet-O-Vator itself. So get this. So you can see just by actuating it, it's just going ahead and changing the length of the cable. And we'll go back the other way. Okay, so far, pretty basic system. You got an electric motor on a worm drive, actuating a Bowden cable, not too complicated. The part where it gets complicated is how this cable goes ahead and connects into the transom, and then how it operates off the pump. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the pump off the bench. I'm gonna go and see if I can get this transom mocked up for you and get some of the cables mocked up. And I really wanna do a decent job of showing you how this operates, because the first time I encountered one of these, it did take me quite a while of looking at it and just trying to understand how it operated so I can make the needed adjustments I wanted to. I wanna go ahead and expedite that for you guys and make it easy. So let me set this down, get everything set up, and I'll bring you back here in a second. All right, so we have the control box and motor up on my toolbox, and we have the Bowden cable that's attached to it that runs back and to the transom. Here's where it gets weird. You have to drill an additional hole below the original steering tube hole, and that Bowden cable bolts into the transom. Now, you would have to take your normal steering tube out, and you'd have your steering tube here with this jam nut. It'd have a piece of rubber O-ring and this other jam nut, and that's where your normal steering cable would come through. You have to go ahead and pop that out. And these are some of the pieces that I mentioned that you can't get anymore, but you have to have these in order to make this work. There's this plastic adapter that you're going to install through the transom and this rubber grommet on the back side. Now this plastic adapter has a rubber O-ring on the inside, and it's gonna go ahead and allow us to run the new steering tube through the transom. I need both hands, so I'm gonna go ahead and set you down, install this plug, get the tube in, I'll bring you right back. Now I need to go ahead and take the specific steering tube that comes with this kit and get it installed onto our existing steering cable, and we can just go ahead and thread that in. Now is where it starts to get a little weird. And there's an additional bracket that we need to go ahead and slide on to the steering tube. And we'll just leave it loose on there for now. And then there's this spring that goes on there as well. Now that we have the steering tube onto the steering cable, our end stop and our spring, we're gonna go ahead and slide this through that plastic piece we installed in the transom. Now that O-ring that's on that plastic piece is what's gonna make this a watertight seal in the steering cable, and it's gonna prevent any water from leaking in. So that's why it's a pretty important piece. And just install it like so. Let me get this cable up here. All right. Okay, now that we have both cables set up, I want to go over it again because it starts to get a little confusing, especially if you have this in the boat and your transom's on. It's typically pretty hard to see this junction back here, and this is the area where it kind of gets confusing to understand what's happening. So, once again, lower cable is out of the Jet-O-Vator box. It goes in to the front side of the transom, and it's bolted on. Our normal steering cable, this bigger cable here on top, runs in, it has the new steering tube, we've added this additional bracket and spring, it goes through that plastic plug that we installed and out this other side. Now I'll need to set the camera down, but I can show you that this steering tube will slide in and out of that plastic plug. In addition, we can go ahead and pull and extend the steering cable itself. So there's basically two moments of movement that we have here versus the original setup that had a steering tube bolted to the transom and only the cable moved. Now this tube moves and the cable moves. One thing I didn't mention when I had this plastic plug out that I didn't show you is there's a little like ball embedded into it, and that prevents it from sitting flush to the back of the transom. Now the reason why they have that is it's going to allow it to articulate some, and it gives it some movement. That's why we have this rubber piece that comes in on the back side. You silicone it up to the transom, zip tie it around the plug, and that'll make it watertight. The O-ring makes it watertight to the steering tube, to the plastic piece, and then you just rely on the fit of the shaft here through the steering tube for that watertight seal. Now I'm going to need both hands here, so I'm going to set the camera down and we're going to continue showing you how this sets up to the pump. Okay, just for the sake of thoroughness, I'm going to slide this rubber piece on so you have a good idea of how it fits. And now that I have both hands, I can show you that the steering tube moves in and out, and also our steering cable moves in and out independently of one another. Now the next steps is you would be having a jam nut back here on the steering tube, and that sole purpose is only to lock in the actuator arm that you have for the Jet-O-Vator. So we'll get this threaded on just a little bit. That'll be good. And then the Jet-O-Vator arm actually goes over the steering end of the cable and threads on to the steering tube. And just like that. And now lastly, in order to get the steering linkage on, there's an extra bar and bracket system. And we'll just go ahead and fish that through right now. And I'll throw this cotter pin in so I don't have to worry about it all falling out on me. So you can see here, this is still our steering control. That's the cable that runs on the inside of the Bowden cable. This is our Jet-O-Vator trim control, and it runs on the steering tube. But the steering tube is essentially attached back here to the steering cable. So the way this functions is, in order to adjust the Jet-O-Vator, it pulls and pushes the steering cable in and out of the transom. So to adjust the Jet-O-Vator, it pushes and pulls the entire steering cable in and out of the transom. Now it achieves that off this Jet-O-Vator cable. Now I have it ran all the way in, so I need to run the motor the other direction, and I'll show you how they connect and show you how this unit functions. Okay, now with this cable pulled back, you can see that it lines up here with this mount quite a bit better, and it actually has this attachment hardware where I can go ahead and attach this cable and affix it to this mount here that's on this steering tube. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this bolted up and then we'll continue on. So now you can clearly see we have our Jet-O-Vator cable, which is securely attached to the steering tube, which is attached to the sheathing of the steering cable. Jet-O-Vator cable is just terminated here in the transom and bolted on tight. Now we have our Jet-O-Vator control here and our steering control. Now, as I showed earlier, steering control is completely separate. I can move that in and out. And in order to operate the Jet-O-Vator control, by running that electric motor, it's gonna pull this cable in, which is actually gonna take the steering cable and push it through the plastic adapter in the transom and push that out. So the spring is here to help return that cable. And this here would be your adjustment for this setup. And we're basically leveraging the transom to take the steering cable and pull the steering cable in and out, which will adjust our Jet-O-Vator. I'm gonna set you guys down. I'll run back up to the motor. I'm going to go ahead and operate this so you can see how it functions. So you can see I just went ahead and pushed this all the way out, which would be pushing the nozzle all the way in the down position. And as you watched on the video, the steering didn't change at all in relation to where the Jet-O-Vator is at. I'm going to go ahead and pull this back. It's going to bring this back in, which would be all the way in the up position. Keep an eye here if you didn't on the first time, and you'll notice that the steering stays at the same length. I'm essentially sliding the entire steering cable, outer sheath and inner sheath, in and out of the transom. I'm going to go ahead and run this back. And there you go. Like I mentioned, it's a very clever setup, but it is a bit complicated to understand. And the biggest downside, as you saw, is when you run this system and you push this steering shaft out, it's also moving your steering input quite a bit. So that means, as I mentioned in my video where I compared this to a place diverter, when I go ahead and trim this nozzle up, like so, it goes ahead and not only am I pulling my steering in, but it's pulling and acting off my steering arm here, which will change your steering of the boat a little bit. So as what I noticed when I was using this, if I would go ahead and trim this in, it would just very slightly take the steering wheel and slowly just kind of turn it as the nozzle would adjust. It was nothing dramatic, nothing big, but it is one downside to the system. And the other downside is probably the complexity. I see a lot of people mention that these units, they go bad, but there's really not a lot here that can fail and go bad on these, and parts are pretty easy to find. Like I mentioned, old GM window motor, you can see the label there on this replacement. You need to replace that, easy enough to do. Very basic micro switches here for the end limits, and just get a potentiometer. Like I mentioned, I use one off of a fuel gauge, get one for the resistance that matches your trim gauge, and I would be surprised if you damage any of this bigger mechanical stuff in there. It's all pretty robust. This one's been, you know, maintained through the years. Functions great. All right, so on the nozzle itself, now that you've seen how the cable system works, this is pretty self-explanatory. This here is the Jet-O-Vator adjustment, which that other white aluminum bracket bolts to, and the steering cable still bolts here to the steering arm to go ahead and steer the nozzle. And you can see how they operate independently of one another. You're going to run that electric motor. It's going to pull the entire steering cable through the transom, and it's going to go ahead and pull the Jet-O-Vator up or down as you need. And when you steer the boat, you're only going to be moving the inner part of the cable, which is going to go ahead and steer your nozzle. All right, guys, like I mentioned, it's a very clever setup, how they engineered this to make it work. It's a little bit complicated, so it takes a little bit to understand it. Hopefully this video really makes it a lot easier for you guys, made it easy to understand, and now you can see how the system works. So if you're running an older Jet-O-Vator system and you have a problem, you know what to chase after, or if you happen to find one for sale, you know what pieces you need, and you also know how it all works, so that way you can get it installed. If you guys liked the video, I'd really appreciate it if you gave me a comment, hit the like button. Really appreciate the support. If you haven't already, I'd really appreciate it if you consider subscribing to the channel. For those of you that have already subscribed, I really appreciate it. Thank you for the support. We'll see you on the next video, guys. Thanks for watching.